What I'd like to talk to you about now is this getting in control of your database. We showed in previous videos that you can oversubscribe a database by too much connections or just by too much workload coming on the system. This can lead to oversubscription of the system that can render the system unstable. Now, when a system becomes unstable, it becomes unstable in many ways in terms of the performance, but what is more sinister about it, it becomes almost impossible to debug a system when it is rendered unstable. I'm not sure how many of you have got to the situation where a system is so oversubscribed that you can't even use the keyboard. You've tried hitting away at the keyboard and no response time. If you can't get any keyboard response, the chance of you actually getting any effective tracing information to escalate and find out what went on, and you've probably also found that things like Enterprise Manager and your operating system utilities are now reporting some fairly strange statistics, because if the actual monitoring utilities are struggle to getting scheduled, there's as will the database requests, you have an unstable system. So to be proactive on these side of things, if you could actually manage the system a little bit better and actually stop the system from running out of control, and let's face it, this is becoming more and more important where we have all our systems in memory and systems aren't being stalled on I/O and every process becomes runnable immediately, this is going to become more and more important as we move forward, and even more important as we start putting more and more workloads onto the same database or have more databases on a common host. We are effectively going to want to govern and control how much resources a database can take. So we're looking here for two things. We're wanting to dial up and dial down the amount of resources a database uses, not only from a resource planning, but also for a staying in control. Now, one of the tools we have within Oracle is the resource manager in a facility known as instance caging. And what I'd like to show you here on the demo is an idea of just being able to literally control via a throttle how much the database is capable of doing and how many resources it's taking up. So we have the same workload as we ran before. And what we have done is impose some instance caging. And what we've done is we've used instance caging on this demo to make sure that there's no more than 24 database processes running at one point in time. Now, this is our throttle, okay? Because there's 24 cores on this system, 24 processes means that I will only ever get to subscribe a core one-to-one. Now, of course, I may need to be sharing this host with somebody else, another database, another set of applications, or I may want to leave some CPU left lying around such that I can guarantee that I get keyboard interrupts if I have to debug the database. So I can literally dial down the performance at will. So I'm just going to reduce this number a little bit. And you can see that basically now if I make this number 18, we're going to start seeing a little bit of reduction in throughput as you would expect. You're starting to see the CPU drop a little bit. And as a result, because I'm starting to constrain the application and not let it have as much CPU as you would expect, we're seeing an impact on the user response time. The database response time is remaining fairly constant on each call, but we're seeing more queuing in the application server. So you can see fairly quickly, I'm now beginning to turn the throttle. And I can be more aggressive with this as I wish. And in fact, I can bring it down to actually say, I'm only actually going to allow half the cores on the system to get active. And you can see the response time is proportionately increasing. The throughput is dropping, and so is the CPU dropping. At this point in time, I'm very much in control and staying in control of the system rather than the system controlling me. As a result, if there's something going wrong on the system, just say something like an execution plan going awry, I will have enough CPU to go in and get the tracing information, find out which plan went wrong, take corrective measures, and fix the system. If we got to the situation where we were so CPU starved, I would never find out that information. And so actually debugging the root cause of your system outage becomes part of conjecture rather than the fact-based led process. And just to give you another example, I can take it to the next extreme and I can drop it down to only use a quarter of the machine. And as again, you can see a proportional response, throughput dropping, response time going up, and CPU getting reduced back. And likewise, I can wake it up to go back and use all 24 cores at will at the same time. So now I'm in control of what the database does rather than what it does to me. This is going to be, again, reinforced, this is going to be extremely important when we have all memory resident systems where every process becomes runnable. And people migrating from databases that are mainly in disk to all in memory will need to start thinking about resource management in advance of the migration. Because in reality, slow storage is a hardware resource manager. It stops everything and puts things to sleep. And so it stops the CPUs running out of control. When you're not doing any I/O, every process will run and run and run until it oversubscribes the machine. So we need to start thinking about some resource management moving forward when migrating to very fast I/O systems and memory resident systems.